गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, आई एम डॉक्टर देशमुख अमोल जगन्नाथ, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ प्लांट पैथोलॉजी, कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नवसारी एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटी, वघई, गुजरात। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर इन द कोर्स फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ प्लांट पैथोलॉजी ऑफ BSc ऑनर्स एग्रीकल्चर। द टाइटल ऑफ द कोर्स इज फंजाई एंड इट्स क्लासिफिकेशन। So in our previous lecture, we have studied what are the general characteristics of fungi, their reproduction and nomenclature. So we just go through the definition of fungi here. So fungi are defined as microscopic, eukaryotic, achlorophyllous, heterotrophic, unicellular or multicellular organism containing chitin or cellulose in their cell wall and reproduce both sexual and asexual means. Example, unicellular yeast and multicellular molds. So the number of fungi are responsible for causing number of important diseases in field crop, horticulture crop, forest crops, etc. Among them, we know that the multicellular fungus, that is Phytophthora infestans, causes late blight of potato and which leads to occurrence of Irish famine in the world. So, as far as the plant pathology and plant diseases are concerned, the fungal diseases are too much important, and that is why we must have to study about fungi and their classification. So let us see the classification of fungi in detail. So there are number of classifications given by different scientists and which are on the basis of morphological characters of fungi. So first classification was given by Vaughan and Barnes in 1937. Who has divided fungi according to type of mycelium, that is aseptate mycelium and septate mycelium, and they have grouped the fungi which are having aseptate mycelium in phycomycetes, whereas septate mycelium containing fungi were grouped in ascomycete, basidiomycete and deuteromycetes. If we see here, the ascospores, if present, then it is called as ascomycetes. Basidiospore, if present, then it is called as basidiomycetes. And if both ascospore and basidiospore are absent, then it is called deuteromycetes. And here, one thing is that basidiospores are produced exogenously, whereas ascospores are produced endogenously. So, dear students, you please keep your attention towards this classification so that you will get clear-cut idea. So, next, Bessé in 1950 has also given classification. He divided fungi in two groups, one mycetazoa and second true fungi. In case of true fungi, we have divided fungi as lower fungi, phycomycete, and higher fungi, carpomycete. And in case of higher fungi, they have again given three classes, that is ascomycete, basidiomycete, and fungi imperfect. G.M. Smith in 1955 has given the classification of fungi, and he divided fungi in two divisions, one myxomycophyta and second eumycophyta. Under myxomycophyta, there are three classes which contain myxomycete, slime molds, plasmodiophorini and acaraceae. In case of eumycophyta, There are three classes. One is hycomycete, second is ascomycete, third one is basidiomycete, and fourth one is deuteromycete. They have given the key features. That is, hycomycete contain algal fungi, ascomycete contain sac fungi. Means the ascospores which are produced by this ascomycete are present in sac-like structure. It is called as ascus. Basidiomycete called club fungi because it produces basidiocarp. It is called basidium or basidium, on which these basidiospores are produced, and these fruits are just like a club. That is why these fungi are called as club fungi. Deuteromycete called it as imperfect fungi because it does not contain any sexual spore or sexual reproduction is absent here, and in this way G.M. Smith has classified the fungi. Then Alexopoulos in 1961-62 given classification of fungi. He has studied the fungi and placed it in a division called mycota. Then these are subdivided into two subdivisions. One is myxomycotina, which he called as slime molds and contain a class myxomycetes. Second subdivision is eumycotina, true mycotina fungi. And he divided this subdivision into two groups. One, lower fungi, which is having a separate mycelia, and higher fungi, which is having separate mycelia. In case of lower fungi, they have given six classes according to the presence of type of flagella in zoospores, which are motile and asexual spores produced by these lower fungi. So, first class is Pitridiomycetes, which contain one flagella and it is whipless flagella. In case of Hypocotyledonmycetes, it contains one flagella and it is tinsel or feather like. Class Oomycetes contain one tinsel feathery flagella and one whipless flagella. Class Plasmodiophoromycetes contain two flagella and both are whipless flagella. Class Zygomycetes contain aplanospore, or these are not having any flagella type structure. Then Trichomycetes, in which there is absence of this zoospore. So in this way they have classified the lower fungi. In case of higher fungi, he divided it in ascomycetes, basidiomycetes and deuteromycetes. It is ascomycetes contain separate mycelia and ascospore as a sexual spore. Basidiomycetes contain separate mycelia and basidiospore as a sexual spore and deuteromycetes. And then ascomycetes are again subclassified into three subclasses: Hemiascomycetidae, in which ascocarp is not present. Then Euascomycetidae, ascocarp is present. Loculoascomycetidae. Then basidiomycetidae, heterobasidiomycetidae and homobasidiomycetidae. So in this way these are classified. He has also given some suffix. If division of the fungi is there, it will be ended with mycota, subdivision mycotina, class mycetes, subclass mycetidae, order ALES and family ACE. So in this way you must have to keep in mind these suffix. These are very useful. Dear student, then Hawker in 1966 has also classified fungi, and they have classified the fungi in two groups. One, lower fungi, hycomycetes, and second, higher fungi. In case of lower fungi, they have grouped the lower fungi according to uniflagellate zoospore, biflagellate zoospore, and zoospore which is not having any flagella or these are non motile. So in case of uniflagellate, they have given classes just like previous classification: chytridiomycetes, hypochytridiomycetes and plasmodiophoromycetes. Then in case of biflagellate, oomycetes, and in case of group aplanate, they have given classes zygomycetes and trichomycetes, in which there is presence of aplanospore or not motile spore, it is zoospore is absent. In case of higher fungi, they have given two classes, one is ascomycetes and second one is basidiomycetes. So here in case of ascomycetes, subclass Hemiascomycetidae, Euascomycetidae, Loculoascomycetidae and Lobulobeniomycetidae were given according to type of ascus and type of ascocarp present. Then in case of basidiomycetes, Heterobasidiomycetidae and Homobasidiomycetidae, subclasses were given according to the type of basidium or basidiocarp. Then Whitaker in 1969 has also given the classification, and it is one of the most important classification, as it is renowned that Whitaker's five kingdom classification, in which he has divided all the organisms in five kingdoms. One is Monera, second Protista, third fungi, fourth plants, fifth animals. In case of Monera, we have given or they contain Bacteria, actinomycetes, which are prokaryotic organisms. In case of Protista, eukaryotic organism and contain only protozoa. In case of fungi, it again contain eukaryotic organism which contain fungi. Plants, eukaryote, plant and mosses, and animals, eukaryote, arthropods, mammals, man, etc. So here, in case of Whitaker's classification, they have keep the fungi in separate kingdom, that is fungi, and it is having true nucleus, which called as a main characteristic of fungi, that is eukaryotic one. Then Stevenson in 1970 has also given the classification of fungi, and he has kept the fungi in one division, mycota, and they have given six classes. One is chytridiomycetes, second one is oomycetes, third one is zygomycetes, fourth one is ascomycetes, fifth one is basidiomycetes, and sixth one is deuteromycetes. So oomycetes, zygomycetes, ascomycetes and basidiomycetes are the names on the basis of sexual spores they produce. It is oospore, zygospore, ascospore, basidiospore. In case of chytridiomycetes, there is presence of plasmodium, that is multinucleated non-cellular structure, and in case of deuteromycetes, these are asexually reproduced fungi and not contain any sexual spore. So in this way he has classified. Then Ainsworth in 1971 to 1973 given very well defined classification of the fungi, and it is accepted everywhere and it is easily understood. Kingdom fungi, they have divided according to the presence of plasmodium. So what is plasmodium? Plasmodium is, it is a cell which is having multinucleate, that is nuclei are present in more numbers and which is not having cell wall. So if it is present, then it is called as myxomycota. If it is absent, then it is called as eumycota. And he divided myxomycota in different four classes, that is acaricomycetes, hydromyxomycetes, myxomycetes and plasmodiophoromycetes. Eumycota were divided again according to the presence of sexual or asexual spores and type of mycelia. So Mysticomycotina, oocyptate mycelia and production of zoospore, and sexual spore is oospore. Zygomycotina, oocyte mycelia and presence of zygospore as sexuospore and aplanospore as asexuospore. In case of Ascomycotina, presence of septate mycelia and ascospore as a sexuospore. Basidiomycotina, septate mycelia, presence of basidiospore as sexuospore. In case of Deuteromycotina, septate mycelia and sexual reproduction is totally absent or it is not present. In this way, they have classified the fungi in clear-cut manner. After this, Alexopoulos and Mims in 1979 have classified fungi again in kingdom Mycetae, which contain fungi as well as slime molds. They have divided these fungi in three divisions: Gymnomycota, Mastigomycota, and Amastigomycota. And they have given subclasses. Mainly, Amastigomycota contains the true fungi, and here again they have divided this Amastigomycotina in four types of group of fungi: Zygomycotina, Ascomycotina, Basidiomycotina, and Deuteromycotina. Then Alexopoulos, Mims, and Blackwell in 1996 have also given classification of fungi, and they have classified the fungi in three groups: true fungi, staminifera, and slime molds. So there are Chytridiomycota, Zygomycota, Ascomycota, and Basidiomycota are present. In case of staminifera, Oomycota, Hypochytridiomycota, and Labrophyllomycota is present. In case of slime molds, Myxomycota, Plasmodiophoromycota, Dictyocoelomycota, and Acaricomycota are present. So in this way, the classification is given. So one of the recent classification is present in book Introduction to Fungi in 2007, and it is given by McLaughlin and his co-worker 2001, and it is same as that of Alexopoulos and his co-worker given in 1996. They have mainly given or placed fungi in a group Eumycota, in which Basidiomycota, Ascomycota, Zygomycota, and Chytridiomycota are present. And this phylogenetic relationship of fungi and fungus-like organism studied by numbers of mycologists with other group of eukaryota, and the analysis is based on the comparison of 18S rDNA sequences. So this is all about the classification which were given earlier by the number of scientists. So after reviewing different fungal classification, we have come to conclusion that the most accepted fungal classification is based on type of mycelium followed by presence of sexual and asexual reproduction in fungi. And thus we will discuss the following classification in detail, in which true fungi are grouped in Eumycota. They are subdivided into lower fungi and higher fungi according to type of mycelium. Then lower fungi are having two classes: oomycetes, zygomycetes. Higher fungi is having three classes according to the presence of sexual reproduction and absent of sexual reproduction. So if sexual reproduction is present and septate mycelium is present, then there are two classes: ascomycetes and basidiomycetes. And second, if sexual reproduction is absent and septate mycelia is present, then it is divided in deuteromycetes. So here we can see oomycetes are called as water molds because it contain zoospore, which are having locomotory flagella and which can swim in the water. Then it is also called as oogamous fungi, as we know, there is having different types of sexual reproduction. So oogamy type of sexual reproduction is present in oomycetes, that is why it is called as oogamous. Then in case of zygomycetes, gametangel copulation occurs and conjugation of two male and female cell occur, that is why these are called as conjugation fungi. In case of ascomycetes, the ascospores are produced in sac-like structure called as ascus, that is why these fungi are called as sac fungi. In case of basidiomycetes, the basidiospores are produced on basidium or basidiocarp, and which is just like a club, that is why these are called as club fungi. In case of deuteromycetes, the sexual reproduction is absent, and that is why these are called as fungi imperfecti. So this is all about this classification. So we will see in detail all these classes with their characters. So first two classes are oomycetes and zygomycetes. So mainly oomycetes are called as water moles, zygomycetes are called as terrestrial and saprophytic. Mycelium of oomycetes as well as zygomycetes is a septate or sinusoid. Cell wall of both these classes contain cellulose and glucans. Sexual reproduction in case of oomycetes is by means of gametangel contact or oogamous. In case of oogamous, as we know, male cell is motile and female cell is non-motile. In case of zygomycetes, there is gametangel copulation, and which gives rise to conjugative fungi, and which is having either isogamous type of sexual reproduction or heterogamous type of sexual reproduction. Isogamous means the male and female gametes are similar in morphology but different in physiology, whereas in case of heterogamy, the male and female gamete of these fungi are morphologically as well as physiologically dissimilar. In case of oomycetes, a sexual spore is zoospore, and it is the only motile spore in fungi. In case of zygomycetes, these spores are aplanospore, as these are non-motile one. And both these zoospore as well as aplanospore, these are present or produced in a sporangia or asexual footing structure, and that is why it is also called as sporangiospores. So sexual spore of oomycetes is oospore, and it is 2N, that is diploid. In case of zygomycetes, it is zygospore and it is also diploid. Then flagella for locomotion, in case of oomycetes it is present, and it is of two types, either whiplash or tinsel or both. In case of zygomycetes, it is absent. The genera which are present in oomycetes are Ithium, which are causing damping up of vegetable, Phytophthora, late blight of potato, Sclerospora, Pernospora, Plasmophora, Pseudopernospora, Bremia, Bremiella. These are the some of the genus which are belongs to this oomycetes and causes down mildew diseases. It also contain genus Albigo, which cause white rust in crucifer. In case of zygomycetes, two genus are present. One is Rhizopus, second one is Mucor. Rhizopus is also called as black bread mold, and as far as plant pathology is concerned, it is called as laboratory weed, because the contamination of this Rhizopus is mainly occurred in the plant pathological laboratory. Rhizopus is also responsible for causing soft rot of fruits, say for example apple. Then mucor is called as dung mold, and it is as grow on dung, it is called as carpophyllus. And both the rhizopus and mucor are responsible for fermentation and alcohol production. They are also produce various organic acids. in case of zygomycetes, one of the main feature is that they produces the sporangium, which are thrown away by this fungus, and that is why these are called as secreting fungus. And both the rhizopus and mucor are the example of this secreting fungus. In some of the fungal classification, both oomycetes and zygomycetes came under the group of lower fungi called phycomycetes. So here one must have to keep note of this point. If anyone asks in your exam to give general characteristic of either oomycetes or zygomycetes or phycomycetes, so you can easily describe the same. Then you have also give the difference between oomycetes and zygomycetes. In this way you can explain each and everything. Then we will see the life cycle of oomycetes and zygomycetes. If we see the life cycle of oomycetes, here there are two life cycle. One is asexual life cycle and another is sexual life cycle. If we study the asexual life cycle, here we can say that there is presence of mycelia which is not having crosswalk. It means it is a separate mycelium. It will germinate and gives rise to sporangiophore, which bears sporangia. Now it contains zoospore. Then they are having two genus. One is Pythium and second one is Phytophthora. In case of Pythium, there is formation of vesicle, and in which there is formation of zoospore present. In case of Phytophthora, directly the zoospores are produced in sporangia. So here it is Pythium. So these zoospores are released from the sporangia, and these are having whiplash and tinsel type of flagella. So whiplash just like a whip and tinsel just like a feather. After some time, the flagella were removed out. It is called as incysted condition, and cysts are formed. These cysts are gives rise to germination, and after germination they produces a separate mycelia again. So this is all about asexual life cycle of this oomycetous fungi. In case of sexual life cycle, we can see here, in case of asepted mycelia, there are two types of cell. One is donor cell, which is called as antheridium. Second one is oogonium, that is receptive cell or female cell. So these are come in contact. That is why we called it as gametangel contact. In some of the cases, this antheridium or male cell are motile one, and that is why we called it as oogamy. After gametangel contact, there is plasmogamy occur, that is protoplasm of both the cell come together. Then both the karyons are come together, that is karyogamy occurs. And then after karyogamy, this oospore is formed, and it is having 2N or diploid oospore. After getting favorable condition, these oospores are germinated and produce hyphae, and these hyphae are non-septate or aseptate or sinusitic one. So in this way we have studied the life cycle of these oomycetes. So dear student, one may ask to give the general characters of oomycetes and explain the life cycle of these oomycetes, then you can easily explain the one. After the life cycle of oomycetes, we must have to study the another life cycle, that is life cycle of zygomycetes. So in case of zygomycetes also, there are two types of लाइफ साइकिल, वन इज असेक्सुअल लाइफ साइकिल एंड सेकंड वन इज सेक्सुअल लाइफ साइकिल. इन केस ऑफ असेक्सुअल लाइफ साइकिल सिनोसाइटिक हाइपा इज गिव्स राइज टू प्रोडक्शन ऑफ स्पोरेंजिया ऑन स्पोरेंजियोपोर. दीज स्पोरेंजिया आर प्रोड्यूसेस स्पोर्स विच आर नॉन मोटाइल एंड दैट इज वाई दीज स्पोरेंजियोस्पोर्स आर कॉल्ड एज एप्लैनोस्पोर्स. दीज एप्लैनोस्पोर्स आर जर्मिनेटेड एंड गिव्स राइज टू सिनोसाइटिक हाइपा. सो ऑल दिस इज अबाउट असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. While sexual reproduction phase, this synocytic hypa is having male, that is donor cell, and female, that is receptive cell or negative cell, and these two cells are come together or joined together by means of gametangial copulation, that is the protoplasm of both the cells come together and both the cells are merged into one cell which contain both nucleus of both the cells, and after karyogamy they are converted into diploid condition, 2n condition, and it is called as zygospore. So zygospore, it is also diploid one, and after zygospore formation these are get converted into haploid by means of meiosis, and these are called as meiospores. They get germinated and again they form sporangium on sporangiopore, and it gives rise to aplanospore, and again cycle repeated again and again. So this is all about the life cycle of zygomycetes, which contain asexual as well as sexual life cycles. So dear students, we have gone through the life cycle of oomycetes as well as zygomycetes, and to general characteristics of both these classes. Now let us see the classes of higher fungi, that is basidiomycetes and ascomycetes. So basidiomycetes are called as club fungi because they produces their basidiospores on club like basidium or basidiocarp. In case of ascomycetes, these are called as sac fungi because these are producing ascospores in a sac like structure called as ascus. Then mycelia, in case of basidiomycetes it is separate one, as well as ascomycetes it is separate. Cell wall of both these groups contain chitin. Sexual reproduction in case of basidiomycetes is occurred by somatogamy. In case of ascomycetes, it is gametangial contact. Sexual spore, which is produced by basidiomycetes, is basidiospore, and ascomycetes is ascospore. The ascospores are produced mainly in 8 number. These are endogenously in a sac-like structure called as ascus in ascocarp. Here, carp means fruit. Asco means ascomycetes fungi fruit. So these are produced endogenously. That is why it is also called as endogenous ascospore. And mainly produces 8 in numbers. We will see the reason why these are produced 8 in number. In case of basidiomycetes, basidiospores spores are generally produced 4 in numbers. And these are produced exogenously on club-shaped basidium on hair-like elongated projection, which is called as steric meter. So fruiting body of basidiomycetes is basidium or basidium. Fruiting body of ascomycetes is ascocarp. There are different types of fruiting body: cleistothecium, which is closed; perithecium, it is postulated opening or flask-shaped; apothecium, it is cup-shaped. Ascostroma, so mycelial or thread like structure or hypa bunch occurs, and in which there is presence of ascus. As far as diagnostic characteristics are concerned, the presence of basidium bearing basidiospore, clamp connection, and dolly percepta are the main features of this basidiomycetes. So what is clamp connection? So in case of pipeline, if we have to divert water from one pipe to another direction, there is one clamp. So likewise, if we have to drive the protoplasm or nucleus from one separate part to another separate part, there is presence of clamp like structure, and these are called as clamp connection. There is also presence of Doley percepta. So it is just like a cylinder type of swelling which are present at separate or cross walls, and these are having pore or small pore like structure, and that is why it is called as Doley percepta. And so both these structures are responsible for causing plasmogamy or karyogamy. In case of ascomycetes, group of ascus are present in fruiting body called as ascocarp, which are enveloped by sheath of sterile hyphae. Basidiomycetes includes the fungi, mainly mushroom, rust and smut fungi. Ascomycetes include fungi, powdery mildew. So in some of the previous classification of fungi, these both classes, basidiomycetes and ascomycetes, came under the group of higher fungi where sexual reproduction is present. So let us see the life cycle of basidiomycetes as well as ascomycetes. If we see the life cycle of basidiomycetes, we start it with basidiospores. Basidiospores get germinated and form monokaryotic hyphae. As we know, the sexual reproduction occur in the basidiomycetes is by somatogamy. So how somatogamy is occurred? The somatogamy is occurs by means of clamp connection. So these clamp like structures are responsible for move out the protoplasm as well as carrion or nucleus of this separate cell to another separate cell. And then there is formation of dikaryotic phase occurred. This dikaryotic phase is prolonged phase, which is followed by short diploid phase. After this dikaryotic phase, there is production of fruit like structure, and it is called as basidium. It is called as basidium or basidium, and it is just like a club. That is why these are called as club fungi. So once again, monokaryotic hyphae come together with somatogamy. Plasmogamy occurs, and due to that dikaryotic phase occur. Then karyogamy occurs, and a cell is formed. It is called as basidium, which contain diploid cell. After meiosis, this particular diploid cell converted into four haploid cells, and this four haploid cell is further gives rise to basidiospore on elongated hair like projection. It is called as sterigmata. After the production of these basidiospores, they are liberated, and whenever favorable condition occur, these are get germinated and gives rise to monokaryotic hyphae. And again, this life cycle is completed, or it comes again and again. So in this way, you have to keep in mind the life cycle of this basidiomycetes. It is very interesting one. Then second life cycle is ascomycetous life cycle. In case of ascomycetous also, there are two type of life cycle is present. One is asexual reproduction, second is sexual reproduction. So in case of asexual reproduction, the asexual reproduction is occurred by means of fission, by means of fragmentation, by means of chlamydospore formation, or by means of formation of conidiophore on which there is presence of conidia. So in this way, asexual reproduction is occurred where mitosis gives rise to spores, which are haploid one. Then in case of sexual reproduction, the particular mycelia contain two types of cell. One is male cell, it is called as antheridium. Second one is female cell, which is called as ascogonia. So gametangial contact of these both the cell occur. And after that, there is plasmogamy occur, which gives rise to dikaryotic hyphae in case of ascocarp. Which dikaryotic hyphae then further go through the meiosis and produces four ascospores are produced. And these four ascospores or meiospores, they again gone through the mitosis, and due to that there is presence of 8 ascospores. So in case of basidiospore only meiosis occur, while in case of ascomycetes meiosis followed by mitosis occur, and due to that there is presence of 8 ascospores. So you must have to keep in mind. So these ascospores, whenever get favorable condition, they get germinated and gives rise to mycelia, which are separate mycelia, and further they again gone under for sexual type of reproduction or sexual type of reproduction, and these cycles repeated again and again. So in this way you have to keep in mind all the points. So now, dear student, we come to the fifth class, that is deuteromycetes. These are called as imperfect fungi or mitosporic fungi because sexual reproduction is absent here, only asexual reproduction is present. Mycelia of these deuteromycetes are separate. Cell wall is having chitin. Sexual reproduction is generally absent. Asexual spore is conidia. Asexual footing body developed is acerolus or pycnidia, and it includes polytrichum, which causes anthracnose, alternaria, early blight of potato, fusarium, wilt disease. In case of deuteromycetes, some of the fungal genera are also form sexual or perfect stages, and these are called as teleomorphic stages. Morph matlab means form, and teleo matlab means sexual form. And while it is also having asexual form, it is called as anomorph, that is asexual form. So here example is colotricum, it is anamorphic stage, while glomerula, it is teleomorphic stage. Let us see the life cycle of deuteromycetes. So in case of life cycle of deuteromycetes, there is only asexual life cycle is present and sexual life cycle is absent. And so here these signs are given. In case of asexual life cycle, mycelia get germinated, then sporangiophore or conidiophore are formed, on which conidia are produced, or they may form asexual footing structure in which conidia are formed. In this way asexual reproduction takes place. But some of the deuteromycetes fungi are also gone through sexual reproduction by means of plasmogamy, karyogamy and meiosis, and they also produce perfect stages, and these stages are called as teleomorphic stages. So once again we recall the example of Colotricum species. So Colotricum is anamorphic stage, while glomerula, it is teleomorphic stage, which is present in deuteromycetes. So dear students, we have come to conclusion here that the fungi are mainly divided into 5 classes. One is zygomycetes, second one is oomycetes, third one is ascomycetes, फोर्थ वन इज बेसिडोमाइसिट्स एंड फिफ्थ वन इज ड्यूट्रोमाइसिट्स. इन केस ऑफ ड्यूट्रोमाइसिट असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इज ओनली प्रेजेंट, दैट इज वाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज फंजाई इम्परफेक्टिव, वाइल इन अदर क्लासेस देयर इज प्रेजेंस ऑफ सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड ऑल द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एज वेल एज लाइफ साइकल्स ऑफ दिस ऑल द फंजाई और ऑल द ग्रुप ऑफ फंजाई. सो यू मस्ट हैव टू कीप इन माइंड ऑल द कैरेक्टर्स. वन मे आस्क इन योर एग्जाम गिव डिफरेंस बिटवीन एस्कोमाइसिट्स एंड जाइगोमाइसिट्स और जाइगोमाइसिट्स एंड बेसिडियोमाइसिट्स और लाइकवाइज. और यू मे आस्क अबाउट डिस्क्राइबिंग द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ आइदर ओमाइसिट्स और बेसिडियोमाइसिट्स और जाइगोमाइसिट्स. सो यू कैन डिस्क्राइब इन दिस वे. इट इज वेरी सिंपल इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड एवरीथिंग in easy manner. So after discussing all these classes, we now see the actual classification of the fungi in detail. So the fungi are come under the kingdom Mycota. These are divided into two divisions. One is Myxomycota and second one is Eumycota. Eu means true, mycota means fungi. Myxomycota, mycota means fungi, and myxo means assimilative or not that much true or false fungi. So how they are classified? So they are classified on the basis of presence of plasmodium or pseudoplasmodium. What is plasmodium? So it is a cell which is not having cell wall and contain numbers of nucleus at a single time. In simple word, it is a multinucleated wall-less cell. So if it is present, then these fungi are divided in Myxomycota, and if this plasmodium is absent, then these are divided in Eumycota, which is having filamentous type fungi. So here we will see the division Myxomycota. So in case of division Myxomycota, if the fungi are free living and just like a amoebae type and having pseudomycelium or false mycelium present before reproduction, then it comes under the class Acrasiomycetes, and genera are Acrasis and Gutlina. So this is amoebae. Then second one is fungi which contain plasmodium, that is multinucleated wall-less cell. This comes under class Hydromyxomycetes. Then third one is having plasmodium, but it is not just like a exact plasmodium or not a net plasmodium. It is saprophytic, which contain class Myxomycetes. Then fourth one is assimilative phase. It is also not having net plasmodium, but contain multinucleated cells, and it is just like a club-like structure produced. And the genus comes under the class Plasmodiophoromycetes, is Plasmodiophora brassicae, which can cause club root of crucifer in the plant. So this is one of the important genus as far as plant pathology is concerned. So the division Myxomycota has divided into four classes on the basis of presence or pseudo presence of these plasmodia like structures. So let us see the division eumycota in detail. So in case of eumycota, first subdivision is mastocomycotina, where motile cells or zoospore are present as asexual stage, and sexual stage is oospore, and it is occurred by means of gametangential contact or oogamy. So here it is zoospore which is having whipless and tinsel or feathery like flagella, and here antheridium and oogonium gives rise to oospore, which are diploid one, and these are placed in subdivision mastocomycotina. Then mastocomycotina have three classes based on the type of zoospore and type of flagella they present. If zoospore is having whipless type flagella and it is single, then it comes under the class Chytridiomycetes. Example of the genus are Olpidium and Cetinchrysidium. Then if zoospore are uniflagellate and having tinsel or feathery flagella, then it comes under class Hypochytridiomycetes. Example of are Residiomycetes and Residiomycopsis. If zoospores are biflagellate, which contain one whipless and another tinsel flagellum, and the size of this zoospore, it may be kidney shape, it may be pear shape, or etc. Then it comes under the class oomycetes, which contain Pythium, Phytophthora, and etc. genus. So in this way, you must have to keep in mind the classification of mastocomycotina. So I have given here separate for each subdivision, so that if anyone asks in your exam, you can easily write or easily explain. Then third class or third subdivision is zygomycotina. So in case of zygomycotina, again motile cell are absent and sexual spore is present, which is zygospore. These zygospores are formed by conjugation or gametangential copulation, and which is diploid one. So zygomycotina, if it is saprobic or if parasitic on pediaceous having mycelium immersed in host tissue, then this comes under class zygomycetes. Example Rhizopus, Coclonema. If these are associated with arthropods and mycelium is not immersed in host tissue, so here mycelium is immersed in host tissue, here it is not immersed in host tissue, then the class is trichomycetes, which contain the genus Acellaria enterobotrytis. Here I want to show or pinpoint here one point, that Rhizopus and mucor are present, which Rhizopus is causing soft rot in numbers of fruit, and these are also responsible for fermentation. These types of fungi are also called as spiriting fungi because they throw out the sporangium from one place to another place, and the asexual spore which is produced by this zygomycotina is also a sporangiospore, but it is non-motile, and that is why it is called as aplanospore. So in this way you can also write the general characteristic of this zygomycotina and explain the classification over here. Then third class or subdivision is ascomycotina. So in case of ascomycotina, there is presence of perfect state or perfect spore, ascospore, which are present in ascus or sac-like structure. That is why it is called as sac fungi. It is having septate mycelia. Now the subdivision ascomycotina is subdivided into six different classes according to the presence of ascocarp or type of ascocarp. So if ascocarp is absent, here you can see ascus are naked, there is no fruiting body, and that is why it is called as naked asker. If it is like this, then it comes under class hemiascomycetes. Examples are Potomyces and Taphrina genus. Then if ascocarp is present and it is just like a ascostroma. So what is stroma? Stroma is nothing but the network of mycelium which forms like a fruit and in which there is presence of ascus which contain ascospores. So if ascostroma is present, then class loculoascomycetes, examples are Venturia, Pleospora, Mycosporella, etc. Then if ascocarp is completely closed and it is cleistothecin, then it comes under the class Clectomycetes, examples are Erysipelagus. Then if ascocarp is just like a perithecin, then they are divided into two types. If it is ectoparasitic one, then class is Lobulobeniomycetes, genus Lobulobenia and Stigmatomycetes. And if it is not ectophytic or it is endophytic one, then the class is Pyrenomycetes, example Claviceps and Xylaria. So perithecium, it is nothing but the flask shaped fruiting body or ascocarp. If ascocarp is as like as apothecium, it is cup shaped ascocarp is present, then it comes under the class Discomycetes, example Pagisa and Ascobulus. So these Ascomycotina, there are different types of powder mildews, Taphrina, leaf cover. Again, some of the commercial mushroom species are also belongs to this Ascomycotina. So dear students, you can explain or give classification of Ascomycotina in this way, so that it is very clear to that particular teacher to evaluate your knowledge. Then next subdivision is Basidiomycotina. So in case of Basidiomycotina, again perfect state or spore is basidiospore, which is present on dome or club like structure. It is called as Basidium or Basidium. And it is generally produced on elongated thread like or hair like structures. It is called as Stericmata. This subdivision Basidiomycotina is also classified into three different classes according to the presence or type of Basidiocarp. If Basidiocarp is lacking and basidiospores are produced as on the mycelia, then it is comes under the class Teleomycetes. And so Puccinia, rust and Ostilago, smut fungi are belongs to this class Teleomycetes. So here you can see there is no production of Basidium or Basidium. So septate Basidium is produced after the germination of Teleospores and Basidiospores are formed. So Basidiocarp is lacking. Then if Basidiocarp is present and if it is gymnocarpus or semi-angiocarpus. So what is gymnocarpus? So these are the fruits which are open fruits. So these are comes under gymnocarpus or semi-angiocarpus. So open fruiting structure or where there is basidiospores are present, these structures are open one. And that is why it is comes under the class Hymenomycetes. So Basidiocarp of agaricus, that is mushroom. So the example of genus are agaricus and polyporus. If Basidiocarp is present and it is typically angiocarpus, it means the fruiting body which are closed one, and in closed fruits there is presence of basidiospores. So Basidiocarp of Kythus and geostrum are come under this class, and the name of the class is gastrocnemacids. So in this way we can classify the basidiomycotina. So you can easily write it in your exam. Then another class is, or subdivision is, deuteromycotina, where is main feature is there is absence of perfect state, or asexual reproduction is only present. So these subdivision are again classified according to type of mycelia or type of fruiting body they develop. So if true mycelia is lacking or not well developed, then it comes under the class blastomycetes, where blastospores are produced by means of budding. So budding of these fungi occurs. Example, Sporobolomyces bullera. If true mycelium present, but the conidiae are formed on sterile separate mycelium on conidiophore, then it is called as the class hypomycetes, which contain the genera Alternaria, Botrytis, Rhizoctonia, etc. When these true myceliums are aggregated and form the fruit-like structures, just as Pycnidium or Acervolus, here we can see it is Acervolus, which contain conidia or asexual spores of that particular fungus, then it came under the class Coelomycetes. And examples are Colotricum pestilosia, which forms Acervolus, where Pomopsis, they are producing Pycnidia. So these types of genus are present. So dear students, you can also explain this Deuteromycotina in detail with giving example of genus in your exam. So this is all about the classification in detail. So in your exam, one may ask to give classification of fungi up to order. So I have just given or enlist out this classification, which is given by Ainsworth in 1971. So again, Myxomycota, Eumycota. In case of Eumycota, if motile cell present, then subdivision is Mastigomycotina. If motile cell absent and perfect state present, subdivisions are Zygomycotina, Ascomycotina, Basidiomycotina. If motile cell absent and perfect state is also absent, then subdivision Deuteromycotina. In case of Mastigomycotina, classes Pycnidiomycetes, Hypopycnidiomycetes, Oomycetes, Plasmodiophoromycetes, and these are orders. In case of Zygomycotina, classes are Zygomycetes, Trichomycetes, and these are orders. In case of Ascomycotina, classes are Hemiascomycetes, Loculoascomycetes, Plectomycetes, Labeloascomycetes, Pyrenomycetes, and Discomycetes, and orders are likewise. And in case of Basidiomycotina also, classes are Teleomycetes, Hymenomycetes, and Gastrocnemacids, and there are different orders. In case of Deuteromycotina, classes are Blastomycetes, Hypomycetes, and Coelomycetes. And we have already discussed about the general characteristic of each and every class in detail in previous classification. So if anybody asks to write or describe the classification of fungi up to order, then you can write this classification. Or if they ask for or to give classification up to class and enlisting genus, then you must have to write the previous classification. Both the classification are easy to understand, so you must have to go through this. So all these classification are present in numbers of books, and it is very easy to understand. So dear friend, we have studied here the fungi classification in detail. So what is historical background of this classification? Second, what are the different major classes of this fungi, their general characters and life cycle. And third, the classification in detail up to class, genera, and up to order. So Everything I have explained very easily, and I think you have got clear-cut idea about all these things. If you have found any mistake, or if you have any suggestion, if you have also found any good points, you must have to write in comment box so that I will incorporate during next lecture preparation. Thank you so much.